Today we're answering the question, what is tenancy at will? You'll learn how to use it, when to use it, and why we use it. Let's dive in. I'm Jenn McPhillamey. We're here with Moe Househh, a real estate lawyer and a family law lawyer at HEALEY Law. Quickly, if this is your first time watching one of my videos, please don't forget to subscribe below so you don't miss any other informative videos like this. So Moe, let's talk tenancy at will. What is tenancy at will?
So tenancy at will is a simple agreement between the purchaser and the seller of a home where if for an unfortunate reason, the funds cannot be transferred on closing day. The purchaser of the home will live as a tenant in that property until the funds are transferred.
So what is needed to get tenancy at will when you're otherwise unable to close?
So there are three things needed. The first thing is the shortfall. The second thing is the home insurance that must start on the closing date. And the third thing would be the signature of the client on the tenancy at will agreement.
Okay, great. And why would the buyer's lawyer be unable to get the mortgage money to the seller's lawyer?
Usually the case, a tenancy at will occurs when broker conditions have not been met yet. And that's honestly most of the time what it is. There are some odd cases that can occur where funds are transferred on closing date, but most of the time it is from broker conditions.
So are there standard terms for tenancy at will?
There are many terms in a tenancy at will agreement, and you will review them with your lawyer once you are signing it. But there are three main ones to have knowledge of. The first one is that the interest rate that you will be paying on a daily basis that you are living in the home as a tenant. The second main term would be an eviction notice. That would be done by the vendor once both parties are aware that the deal is actually not going to go through. So once the tenant receives the notice, with written notice within 48 hours, he and his belongings must be removed from the home. And the third main clause would be that renovations or any changes to the home will not be done as long as you're living there as a tenant.
Well, Moe, thank you for taking the time to educate us on tenancy at will. I found this information to be especially helpful. I also think buyers and sellers will be happy to know that there are options rather than just collapsing the deal.
Well, thank you for having me. And you can reach me at 780-439-7700. You can also reach me by way of email at moe@healeylaw.ca.
Awesome. And that information is in the description below if you didn't catch that. Thanks for watching this episode on tenancy at will. I hope you have a better understanding of what that means to you when you're doing a real estate transaction. If you need any advice, help, or you're buying and selling real estate, my information is also in the description below. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thanks, bye.
Thank you.